just wanna know, can you bounce it like a speaker? Moment you walked in this club, I know what you came to do.
John Allen. I'm a singer, musician, and visual artist from Chicago, Southside. Now I'm 22 years old. Who I grew up has an impact on me and my music. Yes. Because coming from the Southside, you see a lot of different things. You kind of grow up really fast. And so it gives you more of an ambition to make real music because Allen, I'm a singer, musician, and visual artist from Chicago, Southside. Now I'm 22 years old.
Okay, do you believe where you grew up has an impact on your music and who you are?
As much as people try to get away from it, in some ways,
sorry. Just repeat what I said because I'm not going to use what I'm talking.
Oh, graffiti and stuff. And as far as singing, started at 7. My mom was like, if you sing this duet with your sister in church, I'm gonna buy you Hercules. And I said, cool.
How would you describe yourself and why would you use those words?
I guess I would have to say ambitious. Because if I want something, I go get it or I work for it until I see it's not a possibility. I'm creative because I'm always drawing, singing, writing, producing, doing something in the arts every day. And I'm brown skinned because I'm brown. Ball is life. My dad had me hooping since I was 4 years old. So hooping every day, shooting 300 shots a day, playing in college. Like NBA was kind of a thing, kind of a goal of mine. But then when freshman year came around, I was like, I made the team, but I don't want to do this every day. I want to go do music. So that stopped that.
Okay.
I write for all the genres. Primarily it's R&B, neo soul, and hip hop. Because that's just a truer story to me. Like, I'm always dealing with some experience with a woman that equates to R&B. And then I rap all the time, so it just comes out that way. I do pop sometimes, not too much country. I said I was gonna be an artist when I was about 6 years old. I said I wouldn't be able to draw everything and make it look exactly like it is. And I remember selling my first drawings when I was 5. And at the age of 11, I helped design the highway. It's kind of like I always knew this is what I was going to do. But as far as singing, when I was 16 years old, I was singing in church a lot. I would go to different churches and I would get the reactions. People would be crying. And I saw it was something a little special to it, so I said, this is what I want to do. I realized I wanted to become an artist when I was about 6 years old. I would look at cartoons, I look at the world around me, and I was like, I can draw this, and I can get paid from it. When I got older, I was about 15, and I would go to Navy Pier and see the different artists draw stuff, and see them rack up 100s and 60s. And one particular time when I went up there, the owner saw my work and he asked me to work for the company. And I was like, okay, I'm going to be an artist. My taste in music, it's diverse. If it sounds good, I like it. Neo-soul, old school, crooner music, back to the, what's the guy's name? Frank Sinatra and all them, you know, it's whatever. If it sounds good, I like it. As it goes, I guess it really turned up when I went to Atlanta. I met Lil Boosie's manager, and he was really fond of my art and my music. So he invited me to come on tour for a week, and I got to see what it was about. I started getting some songs with some of my friends who produced the Mick Jenkins album. And I had a feature on Revolt, which is Diddy's page. After that, you know, I started opening up for David Banner, different artists. This summer, I'm gonna put some songs on Power 92, WGCN. So my journey is pretty much being a solo artist, but a writer as well. Like in the future, my intention is to sell songs to different artists as well as place music in movies and television. And I've already begun to play songs in television. Especially what he did for Justin Bieber, it's really cool.
What's your
favorite music artist? It's Usher. Writer, Neo, producer, Pharrell, or Timberland, one of those. Voice. Like, my pops is a pastor, and like, I think music is almost like that. You have the means to speak to a huge audience about whatever. It's usually dumb stuff nowadays, but if you want to, you can really tell the world whatever you want through a song.
Okay.
Creative, like, you have the ability to make dope stuff. If you're mad and you make a song, it's gonna be dope. If you're happy and you make a song, just do things when they're genuine. Because a lot of times writers, they're given subjects and they have to unnaturally write about it. So it's better when you're actually feeling that way. It's unique because I'm really not trying to be like nobody. I listen to the radio, I listen to Chris Brown. I basically tell my story, and a lot of it's from the South, because Georgia kind of helped me grow into myself, and then I'm going to Clark. And everybody didn't go to HBCU, and like experience the Georgia peaches, all the things that come with that.
Yeah.
The on-camera position, I have credit in the show. At one point I had a trailer, got really cool with the cast, and I got shouted out, recently been shouted out by Lee Daniels on Instagram for a couple of my works, as well as Taraji and Jesse Smollett. When I started last July, I was just an extra. I was in jail with Lucius, and had my afro and the orange jumpsuit. Then from then, they made me a reporter, and then from there, they made me an A&R. A&R is sits in the boardroom. They're around the tables when they're with Lucius and Taraji. And of course, I got paid for all that, but then I got the opportunity to play piano through 20th Century Fox. And at that point, I was getting five times the pay, and I was actually getting credits on the show, so I was no longer extra.